Bole Baba Ki Jai. I'm with Jai Anand, who lives in Bern, Switzerland, and is originally from Italy, and who met Babaji in 1982. Tell us your stories. Bole Baba Ki Jai.
Bole Baba Ki Jai. The story with Babaji, I met him in 82, but I think a lot of people who met Babaji, the story starts with the book of Yogananda Paramahansa, autobiography of a yogi. And the first time I wrote the book, how I see the picture of Babaji, I knew it why I was coming in this life, why I took this body, mm-hmm. was to meet this this master, this yogi. And but it was just, you know, feeling, and at this time there was nothing about Babaji, nobody had seen him, or I didn't know a person who had seen him. And with the time I met, after some years, I met one guy who was meeting Babaji in very early, at the time when in Haidakhan there was just a duni and a very small temple. And he told me his story about Babaji, how it was his experience, and everything for me was wow, it exists, it's here. And so for me was, how to say, his door was open to go on with this dream, with my my search of this master. And then but he couldn't tell me where it was exactly. He just knew, because after, when he ran away, because he had a very strong experience with Babaji, and he ran away because they were around the duni, and the fire in between Babaji and this guy, and suddenly the fire get open, the two flame was stopping, and he saw the Trimurti, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva in Babaji. Instead of Babaji, he saw the Trimurti. So he was so shocked from this experience that he just ran away in night time from the ashram. And so he has we had a really a difficult experience also going back from India to Italy. And he lost a little bit
his mind.
This mind, yes. Mm. It was so strong, the spirit. And but there was this, the same time, Gora Devi, who is from, she comes from Milano. So there was friend of Gora Devi that was coming from holiday close to the place where I was. And he was a very good friend of my sister. So we met together and tell me where I could find Babaji. He gave me the address. He gave me the place, how to go, the train in Bareilly. Bareilly change the train, you go Aldwani, Tam. And I start in 79 a trip to India. At those times we were always going overland, you know. It was a month trip from my place, Milano, close to Milano, to India. It took a month, you know, over Turkey, Iran, Pakistan, and then up in Lahore and over the other side in India. And I was with a friend of mine, and he got sick in Pakistan. He got very sick, and I had to take him back to Italy, so I couldn't arrive to Babaji at this time. I have to say, I was a young man with a lot of, how to say, not problem, but I had a very strong life, let's say, you know, with a very many experience. And now it comes also man some connection. And after 1918, I met Ganga. She was living in my village, in the town where I live. And so I met Ganga, and we come together. She became my girlfriend. And so after in 81, at the end of 81, together with Ganga and other friend, I said, now we go to India and we go to search for Babaji. But I didn't have any more the address. I knew it just as was north of India and somewhere in Kumaon, but not exactly where, because the Bareilly address and everything was gone loose. So I had no idea how to do this. But I started to say, we are going to look, to search for Babaji. So we start, and we travel all over India. But I was never asking, I was just thinking it will come, somebody to tell me where. And one day I was in Benares on the gate, and it was 80, was 81, was end of 81. It was very different from now. There were no many people and just about foreigner, you know. And then I was looking at the gate and I saw maybe 300 meters away somebody, all black, with black dress. And I had the feeling I have to go to talk with this guy, with this person. I don't know if it was a woman or a guy. And so I went to him, hello, how are you? Yeah. And he was an Italian, just coming from Haidakhan, you know. And we started speaking. I said, where do you come from? Italy? Yeah, what to do here? Yeah, you know, I'm coming from Haidakhan. I met Babaji. You should go there because he's very strong. His experience in your life, you have to go. And that. So I said, okay, now is the moment, we can go. But I have to say, this moment I have with Ganga, with Juliana, her name is Juliana, the Ganga was after, yes, Juliana and Juliana. We had a love-hate relationship. You know, she's a very strong woman, I was and I am, I think, a very strong man. So we were a lot of conflict, you know, a lot of fighting. And I decided at this moment I'm not pure enough to go in front of Babaji to meet him. Mm. We go first to Rishikesh. To do some yoga, and then after a while we go to Haidakhan. We went to Rishikesh, and we were with two other friends, my brother and another friend. And so they went straight to Babaji. They said, we don't come, we go to Babaji, to Haidakhan. And I went to Rishikesh, and my brother, after 2 months, Babaji sent him away. He told them, go back to Italy, because they asked if they had to go to renew the visa. The visa was expiring, and Baba said, no, now you have to go back to Italy. You go. Before, to go to Italy, to go back, they came in Rishikesh to tell us what it was, the story with the Babaji. And this was the first time I saw a picture of Babaji, and we sing the arti together in, I get a commotion. And we sing the first time the arti in our kutir in Rishikesh, and I start crying the whole time, you know. It was so powerful, so wow. The first time doing some things like this. And, yeah, then we decided they, after a couple of days, they went back to Delhi to take the flight to Italy. And me and Ganga, we went to Haidakhan. We arrived to Haidakhan because before that, I had a dream. Just before to go to Haidakhan, that I was on the riverbed, on the Gotama Ganga, wearing just a small longi, not a longi, you know, the red one with a small line, white, that you see all over the Indians. Sometimes it's not a longi, it's like this. I was wearing this, taking a bath, and then going to the upstairs. We were arriving from Aldwani, and I thought before, when I had the dream, I thought this is the way where how I have to come to purify myself, and then. But the story was all running, you know, just arriving with a marchacha, with a camion, with a truck, and then come to Babaji. And I remember, before I arrived, I saw Babaji. He was giving the dasam at about 8:30 in the morning, and it was just standing up and coming to watch who is coming. You know, for me it was just this. I saw Babaji looking down, and I met the first with Babaji, and those overwhelmed, I was confused, and all the emotion fighting together. And I arrived to his feet. We took pranam together with Ganga, and Babaji gave us some prasad. And then there was really a playing, a Baba Lila, and then I was first putting my hand to take the prasad. Same time was Ganga putting her hand. And so I took back my hand, and in my mind was, she make always trouble, you know. Babaji, with this prasad, throw it on the ground, shutting, really, it was the moment Shiva, the destroyer, and we say, tomorrow you go. You know, really, out.
To both of you?
Both of us, yes. Mm-hmm. I was shocked, you can imagine. I came also after my all the trip, the travel, the hoping that something was in my life, and this was. But he went to Shastriji in the office and told him where we have to go to sleep. And usually in Haidakhan, the couple was, or you are married, you can stay together, but this time was not possible. So a girl on one side, women on one side, and men on the other side. He put us together behind the kitchen. And there was Prem Baba, and then we were really sorry at the whole story of what was going on. And so we went to Prem Baba, you know, we met Babaji, and the Babaji told us we have to go tomorrow away, and we don't want to go. He said, don't worry, you go to Babaji and you ask. And we went after in the evening, for the evening darshan, and we went together. He said, Babaji, you can stay. Babaji said, 1, 2, 3 days. Typical Babaji, then with the time, I had other time, 1, 2, 3 days, just. And so we stayed there. And I was not really disciplined at this time. And so for me was always to all the rules, to stay in the asam, karma yoga, the stone, and everything was really for me really too much. So I was at the stone. And any stone I took to put in another place was for me. What I'm doing here with the stone, what does it mean? Like this. And one day I was in front of the Italian restaurant, and come Babaji after darshan, 9 o'clock in the morning, came to us. The Italian restaurant was closed because Filippo was just gone, Hare Krishna doctor. I saw there was nobody running the Italian restaurant. So he looked at us and said, the restaurant has to be open. Somebody has to cook the Italian restaurant. For me, it was perfect. I said, okay, no stone anymore. And I asked Prem Singh if he wanted to help in this. I said, no, at all. For me, it's nothing. The Italian restaurant is not... to cook is not my way. So for me, it was okay. So I opened the Italian restaurant. I went to Aduani to buy the stuff, to buy what I needed, you know. And I start a very nice time in America, with Babaji coming often for to ask how it was going. And one day he came and asked me for 200 grams of dal. And then I was sure, Baba, you take. I was just giving some dal, and then he said, how much? I said, Baba, nothing, please. No, everything has to be paid. And he gave me 2 rupees, you know, he had always the money like this, and he said, tak, tak. He gave me the 2 rupees. And for me, I still have the 2 rupees. One for me, one for Ganga. I gave one to Ganga. And this was really quiet, and was I was really sometime in when I was cooking, preparing, and the stillness. Babaji, the other side with the Karma Yogi, with the stick on the wall, and everybody was walking. The oars in the river, the stillness, and the peace, and everything for me was the paradise. I had the experience really like to be in paradise, you know, this is the perfection. You know, you are doing your duty, and there is around all people, brother, and you are with God, and it was really often I had this very good feeling. And I was always confronted for me to for example, the simplest thing, to make the fire, for example, to cook, you know, that just a simple Indian cooking place where you have to put the small wood inside and something like this. And till for a certain time I could get the wood from Indian, from Ram. But after a while he said there is no anymore, because all the villagers, they went to take the wood for themselves. So it was not anymore possible that he could bring also for me. So I went, I had to go myself. And the morning, darshan, I went to Baba before to go to the Italian restaurant and say, Baba, I have to go to the wood, to take wood for the fire. That means that at midday I will not cook. And he looked at me smiling and said, no, you go to take the wood and then you cook at midday. Before, for me, was a good idea, you know, go, I do something else, I go to work in the wood, blah, blah, blah. And then suddenly it becomes a challenge, you know, go to search for wood. And then it was the first time in the wood, and I don't know where and how and what it was. So I was looking around, and I couldn't find really a good wood, you know, small pieces, and in a place I saw a really big tree. Like this?
Big what?
A tree.
A tree.
A complete, how to say, you know?
Branch of a tree.
Branch of a tree, but a very big one. And they had a fawn like this, you know? Just like this. I was taking, and it was not really heavy. I said, okay, I can carry. So I put on my back, I went down to the Italian restaurant. I met Ram. I said, Ram, look, I had the wood. He said, you see, Giuliano, this wood you cannot need, you cannot use. This is not, it doesn't burn, you know. You cannot make fire with them, because this one is a wood that stays in the wood, but you cannot use for to make fire. It was too much. Then I asked to him if I can get from him for the midday lunch to organize, and then he gave me the food. But this was for me, you know, running and always in challenge that Babaji was putting on us. And what I can say again, yeah, all the lila that Baba was making with us. How to say, at this time I was not really confident in myself, you know? And so I was always keeping a distance from Baba. I was never going too close. I remember I was, for example, when we had to make the pranam, you know, Babaji, at the end of the art, he was coming, sitting on this asana, and then he was in line to make a pranam.